here's the starting offense for the visiting Warriors. At quarterback, number 12, Nicholas Galuski. At wide receiver, number 2, Jake Rizzo. At running back, number 27, Charles Radigan. At wide receiver, number 8, Maxwell O'Connor. At running back, number 35, Jacob Keller. On the offensive line, number 65, Sean Lucier. On the offensive line, number 56, Thurston Thomas. On the offensive line, number 77, Liam Rogers. On the offensive line, number 58, Drake Teal Campbell. On the offensive line, number 62, Spencer Agin. And at tight end, number 9, John Welcome. Ladies and gentlemen, now the starting defense for the home standing Dutchman. At defensive line, a senior, number 66, Brendan Dupree. On the defensive line, a sophomore, number 50, Antonio Cipolla. On the defensive line, a senior, number 76, Zach Harrison. At linebacker, a junior, number 15, Connor Dock. At linebacker, a senior, number 23, Quinn Orsini. At linebacker, a senior, number 5, Michael Scuzzarella. At linebacker,
I've seen number one, Troy Bershwinger. At defensive back, a junior, number six, Vinny Cosenza. At defensive back, a senior, number four, Giovanni Simeone. At defensive back, a senior, number 11, Gavin Motto. And at defensive back, a senior, number 8, Justin Kapuscinski.
And Averill Park will start the game receiving. Ladies and gentlemen, will you all please rise, remove your hats, and turn to the flag for the playing of the national anthem.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and we welcome you to another season of Dutchman Football. Tonight will be the matchup between Averill Park and the 1-0 Averill Park Warriors and the 0-0 Gilderland Dutchmen. I'm Anthony Bornt. Averill Park is 1-0 after beating Middletown 26-21, and it was out of conference. Some other matchups before we start here. CBA beat LaSalle 49-0. Saratoga Springs lost to Boston Spa. Boston Spa beat Saratoga Springs 21-7. And East Chester beat Colony Central 40-22. We'll give you more updates as the game progresses, but it's almost about to be game time here in the first quarter. Averill Park against Gilderland High School, and the kick is off. He'll be down around the 28-yard line, and the season is underway. The ball will be placed at around the 28-yard line. First and 10, Averill Park has the ball. Snack from the quarterback. He'll throw. And it is incomplete. Second and 10, Gilderland High School. Second and 10 for Averill Park. Still around the 28-yard line. Number 12 takes a snap. They're going to run it. They're going to hand off up the middle. It'll be taken down at the 34-yard line. It will not be first down. Third down. Third and three for Averill Park. They're back on the line. They're going to take a snap. Oh, he almost gets tackled. They're going to scramble for it, and they do not get the first down. Fourth down for Averill Park. Here's a replay on that, and I mean, oh, number five over there. That is Michael Scusarella, and he almost sacks the quarterback, but he is just short of the first down. Fourth and one, and they are looking. They're going to kick it. They're going to punt it. It is going to bloop in. Down at the 24-yard line, it looks like. And it, after a quick first drive that ends in a punt, the Dutchmen have a first down at replay of the kick. Yep, no one seemed to get that one, but they let it stay. Around the 24-25-yard line. Actually, I might be wrong on that. Sorry. 35-yard line around there. They'll take a snap. They'll run it. And he is going to be taken down. Short game. 2-yard, second down and 8. They're going to go right on the snap again. They're gonna run it again. Averill Park stops him. Third down. Dutchman not getting good help on the run game. Third and 8. They're gonna run it again. Towards the outside. Oh, he gets tackled down. Fourth down. And it's looking like it's the defense shows up in the first two drives of the game. Fourth and 8. They're going to take it, and that kick is going to be punted. Way deep. Way deep. At the 23. What a punt. Oh, I'm sorry about that, folks. 14-yard line. Here we go, first down, Averill Park. Crowd cheering here. They're gonna snap it. It's another run, up the middle. He's got a lot of ground. And he will easily get the first down. Look at this route. Tries to stiff him here. Oh. That looks interesting. To me, it looked like a face mask, but honestly, I don't know. First down for Averill Park. First and 10. Averill Park will take the snap. They're gonna throw. Not complete, incomplete pass. And it'll be second and 10, Averill Park. You can tell this crowd is ready to cheer if this team gets an interception. Here we go. They take a snap. They're going to throw. He'll throw right side. Complete. That is going to be just short. Just short. I can't really tell here. I gotta replay this one. It will be third and a yard. Just short. Just short. Third and 1. He'll take the snap. He'll pass it off. He might be down. They push him back. That'll be a fourth down. Or is it? I'm sorry. Just short. I mean, just barely got it. just got it. Averill Park's drive will continue. .645 left in the first quarter. They'll take a snap. They'll throw right to number two. Oh, what a tackle! Their number two, Jake Rizzo, got that catch. Looked to have a couple of yards. But number 11, Gavin Motto, with a great tackle and a lot of extra help there. Number 15 and number 5. Really good tackle. 6:06 left in the first quarter. It'll be second down. He'll take a snap. He'll throw. Complete to, again, number 2, Jake Rizzo, and he will be down. Yeah. Take a look at that one again. Had a great read. Third and 3. Another good tackle. Here's the hike. They'll run it. Eddie gets tripped. Fourth down. They are going to look to punt it. Fourth and 4. Right next to the right side of the Manahasson M. Twelve's there. They're gonna throw or run. They're gonna go for fourth down. And offsides! Offsides! That's going to really ruin that end of a drive. Timeout. I think I read the lips of that one. They will take a timeout. First timeout. And first corner, still 0-0. We'll be right back. We're back. I don't think they are going for it here. They will punt. A very high punt. Towards the 35-yard line. And it will be first down, Dutchman. They'll set up. They'll hike. They'll run it. Number 8 there. Down. Kapuzinski got that one. Defense held them back. There's a replay on that one. Yeah, immediately got read open like a nice book, and that'll be second down. Small loss on that one, second and 11. They're still ready for it. 3:38 left in the first quarter. Second and 11. They'll throw here. He's going to scramble. And he's got room for a bit. What a scrambling rush for the quarterback. That was number two, Travis Berschwanger. Great rush on that play. Had a lot of room. Tackled good by the defense. But they get more yardage. Third and four, 2:48 around there. Left, fake run, he'll throw. Caught by number one, Troy Berschwanger, and that will be taken for a Dutchman touchdown. The brothers pass to each other, number two to number one, and it'll be 6-0, Gilderland Dutchman. What a play. Great read. First touchdown of the season for the Dutchman. I'm gonna write that down. I don't know what that was, but they're gonna go for a kick. Kick is up, and the kick is good. 7-0, Gilderland High. Brzezinski will kick it off. And here comes the kick. Good kick. Caught by Rizzo. He'll keep going. Down. To around the 26-yard line.
And that was a 50-yard kick.
26, excuse me. It's kind of hard to hear the check. Where the ball's always placed. It's at the angle we're at. But other than that, it's off to a great start for the Dutchman. Our defense is holding up. The brother-to-brother catch with both Troy and with Travis throwing to Troy. And here comes the snap for Averill. Averill Park. He'll throw. Incomplete. Second and 10. Let's look at it again. Almost looked like he slipped a bit, but got up, and it'll be second down and 10. Still at the 26. Here comes the hike. They're gonna fake the run. He'll get it. I don't know where that one, I'm sorry, big excitement. But Kaprzynski again. That should be down at around. I'm sorry. That is a third down. Third and eight for the Warriors of Averill Park. Just to note, ladies and gentlemen, that the reason why we're playing at Monahassan and not Gelderland is because the turf field has not been installed yet. This will happen again for next week's game against, sorry, it'll be also for next week's game at least. That game will be held at Scotia, but the rest of the game, September 30th, and, sorry. Okay. It's complete. Is that the 45? That will be a first down. I'm sorry, I'll go back to what I said. Gelderland schedule will be Averill Park and Colony Central. Colony Central will play at Scotia. That is where they're going to be playing the second home game of the season. The third and fourth home games, which will be against Bethlehem Central, will be the first game played on the new turf field. 54 seconds left. First down, they're gonna run. And he gets a great route. Down at around the 46, 45 yard line. Second and one, just short. I mean, great rush by Averill Park at number 22, which is, actually, I'm sorry, we don't have a profile on him, but number 22, I think, with that great rush. 10 seconds left in the first quarter. This will probably be the last play of the quarter. Right at the 50. They're gonna run outside. He's got all the room in the world. Number 28, touchdown, Averill Park to end the first quarter. Number 28, Jacob Phelps. What a rush. 7-6 at the moment. Well, let's see, I might have mistaken the guy prior to Phelps, but he had a great rush, had a ton of room, and he had all way, a one-way ticket to the end zone. The kick is up, and it's no good. A bad kick by the kicker, and Gelderland High. We'll take a one-point lead as we head into the second quarter. We'll be right back. End of the first, 7-6, Gelderland Dutchman. Thank you. we're back, and whoa, the moon shining bright tonight. So far, no stars are in the sky. Well, we will tell you the temperature right now here in Rotterdam. Temperature, Rotterdam, 75 degrees. It's a cool night for some Friday Night Lights. Went down, 72 now. It is going to be first and 10. They're ready for the hike. The hike is up, they're gonna run. Number 5. That is Michael Scuzzarella. That will be placed at almost at the 25-yard line, is it? Second and 6. They're going to run again. And he's got room! Down! And around 40! First down! And around Averill Park's 40-yard line.
That's a 15-yard run by Gizzy.
Excuse me, the 40-yard line for us. Just had to make sure of that one. They're gonna run again with number 8. Kaprzycki is still going on the Averill Park 39-yard line. But there is a flag, first flag of the game. We'll be holding on the Dutchman. First flag of the game. That'll move him back 10 yards. First and 8. Ten 32 left in the second quarter. Dutchman up 7-6 in the first game of the season. Flags will be whistled. Whistles will be chimed. But something's happening. It'll be 10:15 left. And here they go. Number 12 will scramble for the first down. Number 12, Damian Gizzy. And that will be an easy Gelderland Dutchman first down. 13 yards. Nice rush there. Just if you want to know, sunset at around 7:14. There's going to be a throw. Bullet right to number 8, Justin Kapuscinski. And that will be around the 31-32-yard line. And first down, Dutch. 12 yards. He got tackled around the 34-yard line. And that'll be where the ball will be set. They're going to run it. And he'll get some yardage. Not a lot, but at least some. The fans here going wild. Not even in their new turf field home stadium. Let's take a replay on that. That is Scuzzarella. He is a senior, 5'7". They're gonna run it with Kapuscinski again. And a nice rush. Up the right. Another gain there. Just short. I think they're checking the spot of the ball. They're going to measure it. They are going to measure the spot of the ball. Will it be placed? It's close. It could be short. Or is it good? It will be a first down. Just barely. By probably a couple of inches, got that one through. First and 10. First and 10. They're going to not run it. Gizzy will run. He will get a couple of yards. Here's a replay on that one. The fake rush early on. Gizzy again scrambles for it. He'll be down, and I'd say the 19-yard line. Second and 4 for the Dutchman. Here comes a snap. They're going to run it. He's got a big breakthrough. Touchdown, Dutchman. Scuzzarella with a great read, a great rush. And it will be 13-6. Gilderland, Dutchman. Here's a replay of it. And I mean, he just broke through him. He almost got tackled there. I mean, he got tackled past the end zone line, but still a touchdown. And here comes the kick. Not blocked, but it is good. 14-6, Dutchman. And they've got the early lead. 14-6. We'll be back after a couple of minutes. just in case if you missed it, you won't know where the game is played, because again, we're not at the high school, at least Gilderland's, we're at Mahonison in their field for this game. And it's just off of Carmen Road in Rotterdam. It's 8:07 right now, and they're about, well, time is 8:07, and it's about to be another punt or kickoff. And here they go. They're ready. Here goes the kick. A short kick. Not going to be caught. It'll be around the 24, 25 yard line, but there is a flag. Looks like they're going to re-kick it. They will re-kick it. Get a better kick off. And there we go. I see the fans brought signs. And there goes the kick. At the 15, but he bobbles it. That'll most likely be at the 14-yard line. And that will be first down, Averill Park Warriors. First and 10, Averill Park. And they are ready. They are going to run it as he gets tackled down. Not sure about that one, but it's there. Yeah, 21. They're gonna run it here. A handoff will be good for the first down. Let's take a look at that. They just couldn't tackle him. They kept forcing him going the other way. I mean, I've seen football teams that do that, at least in the beginning stages. It's not good. You want to tackle him the other way. First down. They're at the 35. They're going to go for it. They'll take the snap, and he will scramble. They can't get to him. And he's still going. He's still going. He keeps juking all of them. Wow. Down at the 48. Kept juking him. And only eventually got tackled. A great scramble. This is going to be a good replay. They tried. Unless I missed something. But first down. They'll keep it going. Quick handoff. but it will be wrapped up. Small game. And here goes the defense chance. Let's take a look at that one. Got past the M. I say that's about the other 48. Second and 6. .510 left here in the second quarter and the first half. And they're going to run it. A good run. Someone got tackled good. That will be third down. Look at this rush. Looked good, and he got clobbered. Oof. Third and 2, just short. Easy run, could get it done. 4:28 left in the second quarter. Averill Park ready to take the hike. They'll hand it off. Easy first down. Down. At the 39-yard line. Take a look at that one again. 22. Oh, no, that is right. 22 there. Good run. Got swarmed by the Gilderland Dutchman defense, but it just couldn't. But the defense couldn't push him back. First and 10 at the 39-yard line. 14-6, Gilderland Dutchman. Averill Park ready for their second touchdown of the game, but they can get an easy drive. 3:45 left. They're gonna throw deep. What a catch by number 2, Jake Rizzo. That is a big touchdown. And it will be 14-12. Gilderland Dutchman. What a throw there. Big throw. What a catch by Rizzo. Held him off. Got through the arms of the defender, number 6. Consensa. And he got it. Great touchdown. And it will be 14-12. That's an arena football play right there. And I mean, really, that is an arena football play. I've seen a lot of them. They throw deep to get the big touchdowns, and that's big. They are looking to go for it, ladies and gentlemen. Here they go. They are going to throw it. Easy 2-point conversion. And it's a tie ball game, ladies and gentlemen. 14-14. There is a flag, however. It will be on Averill Park. Here they go. They're going to retry it 5 yards back. It's quiet here, even though Gilderland wants this. They are going to pass, and it's still good. It will be a tie ball game, 14-14. And I mean, wow. The penalty couldn't stop them there. 3:37 left. 14-14. Gilderland, I'm sorry, 14-14 tie. We'll be right back. quarterback. Here comes Averill Park after their two-point conversion to tie the game. Canada Drew. He is looking to kick the ball off. Good. So that they can have the defense do their magic and hopefully get the lead. Crowd does not want that though. They're cheering. Points in the air. And that kick is way deep. It will be recovered by number four, Simeon, and he has got a great recovery. Look at the fans. First down. Close to midfield, what a recovery. Had it done great. It will be on the 44, first and 10. 64 with the snap for Gilderlin. And here comes the hike. It'll be another handoff, but it will be handed off to Travis Verschwinger. Couple yards there. Take a look. Second and 7. Let's take a look at that one more time. It looks like it was handed off to number 5, Scuzzarella, but then it got handed off back to Travis Verschwinger. Interesting play by the Dutchman. And they're going to throw it to number 8, Kapuzinski, and he will get the first down. First down for the Dutchman. And here goes the chance. Short one, but still a chance. This team sees Kapuzinski and has all the support for him. And he had a great move there. It'll be handed off to Travis Verschwinger. He will throw. That is complete. Just barely got the toes in. And that, my friends, is a first down. Let's check that one. That one was close. Oh. That is very close. They are probably checking on that one, unless they're talking. Oh, no, they're talking. That was a close one, real close. First and 10, 2 minutes, so 2 minute warning almost upon us. This'll probably be the last snap before that. Scuzzarella got it, and that's the 2 minute warning. At the 30, second and 7, 2 minute warning. Number 5 there. Scuzzarella, good rush. Looks great. Here comes the next pass. Minute 30 left. Verschwinger will scramble for it. Tackled out of bounds. Is that a first? Third and 3. Just short. Take a replay of that one as well. Verschwinger. Great rush there. Let's tell a bit more about him. Great arm. Oh, and it's behind him. And it will be recovered by Averill Park. A bad snap gives a recovery to Averill Park. However, to the Gilderland fans, do not fear. They will get the ball in the second half. Start the second half. Sorry, but couple seconds left. They will move to the defense now. Here goes Averill Park with the snap. Look at the throw. Short. Is it out? It will not be a first down, but still complete. Second and two. They're gonna hand it off to 28. Scuzzarella. Team has got some key players today. There will be a timeout for Averill Park. Their second of the half. We'll be right back. It's a tie ball game, 14-14. Averill Park will come back from the timeout, 3rd and 3. Welcome back here for the GHS Media Channel on YouTube.com. We're about to set the ball here. Third and 3. Well, there is a bit of a time stoppage. Something's looking to happen here. I don't know what it is. Is he fourth down? Looks like it. The play will go on. Here goes the snap. They're going to throw to Drizzo again. That will be a first down, Averill Park. Warriors playing a good game on offense and a good game on defense. It is a great start for both of these teams, at least. Averill Park barely won in the shootout against Eastchester. I'm sorry, they won against Middletown, 26-21. This is Gilderland's first game of the season. Averill Park has burned two timeouts. Gilderland has not used one of them. Here's a replay on what just happened. They threw. complete. Whoa. They're at a great 30-yard line. The crowd cheering here. Even in a road turf, they're still here. They're gonna throw deep. Incomplete. Dropped just short. Second down. 19 seconds left. And here we go. Down again at the 30. Team ready to roll, entering the second half. As they get on the line. Second and 10, 18 seconds left. They'll throw. Complete by Rizzo again, but they'll push him back. Good. They have one more timeout. Will they burn it? Let's take a replay on that one. Number 12, that is Gizzy. Great throw, good catch by Rizzo. He's been their big receiver, and that will be Averill Park's final timeout of the half. We'll be back in a few. Tie game, 14-14 between Averill Park and the Dutchman. Eight seconds left. We're back. Tie game, 3rd and 5. 8 seconds to go. This is a big moment of the game, ladies and gentlemen. Here comes the snap. It will be caught. It is complete. But I think there is still a second left on the clock. Averill Park can get a touchdown here. Don't call me on that one. Let's see. Do they keep it? This might be the end of the first half. All the fans still standing, waiting for what happened. There will be another play to end this game. There's one more play for Averill Park to get the lead over Gilderland. And here they go to the line. 3rd and 1. Just short. And there will be. They're going to ice him. 1 second left. Gilderland will take their first timeout of the first half. We'll be back in a few. It's 14-14, tie game. Back on. 1 second to go. Do they go for the touchdown, or will they squeak a lead in? They're going to go for the kick. They iced him. And here they go. Crowd cheering as loud as ever. The kick is up. The kick is no good. There will be a flag. Something might have happened here. Could maybe have been something bad, but let's see what the ref in the white hat has to say. Face mask on Averill Park. That most likely will be the end of the first half. But we'll see if they get another play in. A weird ending. At least for me it is. And I think that's it. End of the first half. Here in Manahasset. Unless... it still might be another play. No, I haven't heard anything either from the ref or the press box up here. They're going back out. There will be, I think, another play. Go. Final play. This will. Nope, they kneel it. And that will be the end of the first half. And it's a tie ball game, ladies and gentlemen. 14-14. And what a game this has been. Great plays, great rushes, great defense. Back and forth, back and forth. And we'll see you in a few. This is going to be the GHS halftime. Averill Park 14, Gilderland Dutchman 14. We'll be back in a few.
gentlemen, please get out your 50-50 raffle tickets. 50-50 raffle tickets. Today's winning prize is $217. Please get out your 50-50 raffle tickets. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the winning number is 421-8953. The winning 50-50 raffle ticket number 421-8953. Please come to the announce booth to collect your $217. Out of bounds for a penalty.
Sorry, folks, but we're back. Out of the half, 14-14. Tiger. The second half will start after number 24, Canada Giroux, with the kickoff. And the kick is off and underway with the second half. Who's got it? Number 8, Kapuscinski, who will get tackled down near the 35-yard line. First and 10.
So to start the second half, take over on their own 38-yard line.
On the 33. Sorry, 38. They're going to hand it off.
And hand off. No gain on the play. Thank you.
take a look at that one again. Kabuzinski, short rush. 11:23 left in the first and third quarter. It's shaking here. The cameras are shaking. Hand off to number five. And that, is it good? Just short, third down. Third and nine. To be honest, I thought it was a lot closer, but he got tackled down. Oh, I think I see why. Don't forget about that one. 10:39 left in the third quarter. And they're going to throw it. Bershwinger with the throw. Caught by number 8, Kapuzinski. 10-5. Touchdown, Dutchman. Wow. What did I say earlier about Bershwinger and his arm? He's got one. What a throw by Travis Bershwinger to Kapuzinski. Look at that. Moved right, juked him out, broke a tackle. He'll throw him, the senior co-captain. Look at that. Woo! And they're giving, I think that's Bershwinger with the, he's a freshman chance. Kick is up. Kick. And the kick is good. 7-point lead, 21-14. Dutchman. We'll be back in a few short moments. We're back. Kapuzinski ready to kick it off. He'll put it on the tee. And we'll see how far this one will go. Had some good punts today, I believe. Let's see if he can have a good kickoff. Keep him down low. And here goes the kick. Kind of popped up. No one will catch it. At the 20 is received. He'll keep going. To the 28-yard line. And that's where it'll be, 28-yard line. And that, and Averill Park will get that start done. You can tell how loud and rowdy this crowd is, because the camera's up in the bleachers, and you could see it shake up there. First and 10. They're going to run it, and that's a nice rush. But they do take him down. Might. Number 27 for Averill Park. Charles Radigan. And here goes the defense chance for 3 seconds. Good move by number 13. They got it done. Get the job done. They'll continue it off. There's Here they go. The run. Oh, it's a fake. Throw to number four. And he will be taken down. Dutchmen are up 21-14 in the first game of the regular season for the Dutchmen. They run it, but they'll hold the line. Great move by the defense. That will be 4th and 2. Let's look at that one again. Great one there. It was at number 50. Applied the tackle there. That is Antonio Cipollo. And that will put him at 4th and 2. Most likely would be a punt. Let's see what Averill Park will do. 4th and 2. 21-14. They're going to go for it. 24. He'll go. He'll still go at the 30. Wow. A fake punt will give Averill Park the first down. That might change it. Replay this one. He faked it. 24 kept on running. 24, by the way. 24, candidate Drew. Didn't think on the scouting report he'd have wheels, but he's got it. Broke a tackle there before getting down at around the 30. And wow, that's a big play. Averill Park still with the first down. They're gonna run it. Canada Drew, multi-use running back kicker. And that let's take a look at that one again. I mean, Drew got a couple of yards, pushed a bit ahead, and yeah, great play. 2nd and 5. Averill Park on the 24. Set up. They'll throw right. But he'll get tackled down by number 4, Giovanni Simeone. Take a look at that one, folks. Almost got intercepted. Oh, but he got down and then tackled. Still clobbered the man, though. Whew. 6:23 left in the third quarter. And here go the defense. Six, 10 left, 3rd down. And here they go. Here's the snap. They're gonna throw. He's gonna run. He'll fumble out of bounds. What caused that one? That's going to be a replay. Let's see that one again. 12. Number 12. Galuski tried to get it. But he fumbled it. Luckily for them, it was out of bounds. So I think it will be first down. Wow. Defense back in. They're gonna quick one. We're gonna get a quick one here. They're gonna run with Canada. And that'll be down. Second down. Second and four. Second and five. Just made a correction. Averill Park with the ball. And I mean, what a game this has been. Both teams have great defense to start out. They've both scored great touchdowns. And they've both had great drives. Even though they've made some mistakes, still been good. They will not get them. What a tackle! That's going to be a loss. That was a dead man there. The defenders knew it, and he absolutely gets tackled. Canada Drew, even though he's the kicker, or at least the punter, he still is getting clobbered by this Gilderland defense. 4-0. Oh, excuse me. There will be a timeout by Averill Park. We will be right back. 21-14, Gilderland, Dutchman. We are back. Red Sea getting some hype here. Timeout. Averill Park close to the end zone. But it feels like it's so far away for them. They've been getting stop after stop. They're going to run. They'll get the stop. What a play there. Fourth and five. They're getting it done. Great tackle there. Two piles of bodies. Well, the main one, tackled down. 3:33 left in the third. And now it's fourth down. I wouldn't be shocked if they went for it. There is a flag. Delay of game, pretty sure. On Averill Park, that'll move them back. Delay of game, we'll move back. Look at this Red Sea crowd. Even not really in their home park, they're still cheering a whole lot. It's gonna be fourth and nine. Will they still go for it? Find out on this next play. Here we go. It's shaking. Oh, almost got it. Throw. Incomplete. Gilderland ball. What a play. Almost caught, missed him, and that will be Gilderland ball. Let's take a replay on that one. Number 12, their quarterback, threw it, almost caught by both teams, and it'll be first down, Gilderland Dutchman. They're down a bit short, but this team can make it through this Averill Park defense. The last game Averill Park played, it was close. Real close. Someone's hurt. Number five. Oh, it's been a big part of their team today. Scusarelli looks to be wobbling, getting the help of a trainer. Big blow there. Let's hope he has a good recovery. But we're going to continue this ball game. 21-14, Gelderland ball. And here comes number 12 with Gizzy. He's going to scramble. What a scramble! And he's still going! He passed a 30 right through them all. 3 minutes left in the third. Take a replay on that one. Blazing speed.
And Gizzy with a
22 yards. Wow. Great play there. Now they have even better field position. A lot of good field position. They're ready to keep on going. Gonna take some wild water breaks. There might be a timeout here. Refs are talking. Timeout called. Averill Park ready. First down, Gelderland. First down. Who's got the snap? It's Bershwin. It's not Bershwin. It's number 12, Gizzy. And he's down. That was bad. He went for it. Can't tell if that's a sack. And someone else is hurt. It's Kapuscinski, number 8. Another big blow here. But they're testing him out. He's been one of their best players today. Lost two good guys for this team. Two guys who have performed great for this team. And they are losing a big blow here and losing both. Number 5, Scusarella, and Justin Kapuscinski, number 8. It's rough. It's a rough scene. Never want to see a player get hurt. But with the game of football, I think that's one of the most common things. Someone's gonna get hurt at some point, but he's still down. No, he's back up. He's walking good. That's great. But he'll probably sit out for the rest of this game. Second and 12. He is walking. That's good. That is great for Kapuscinski. There is, I'd say, a chance he'd come back, but we don't know the injury that he had or he has. But we're back. Second and 12. He'll run again. Does he have room? Oh, he stays up. What a play. Wow. There is a flag, however. This could be on the Dutchman. It is holding against the Dutchman. That'll be a couple of yards back. are back. Second and one. Here's the snap. He's getting tackled, and he is sacked. There's a dead man. He got demolished by 56 and 58 and 44. He almost fell down there, I think trying not to get sacked, but he's still down anyway. They're up on the line. 12 will be sacked, fumbled, but I think he's out of bounds. That might have been strategic, but honestly, I don't have a clue. That'll be third. Third down. That's out. No, yeah. That's out. That was fair. It would have been a fumble, but still. They need a big play here. The fans knowing that they need a big play here. Obviously, you can tell that by the camera shaking, but 1:26 left. I think they're punting. Caught by number 5. And he's still going. He's still going. Oh, big hit to number 5, but he is pumped. Mason Brown. That's a good punt from the end zone. I got the tracking well, and he gets it. Let's see it. Almost jukes out number 13. He keeps on going, and he gets through everyone. Still got it. Is now it'll be Averill Park ball, first and 10. Averill Park on the line. They'll snap. 27 will rush. And he'll gain little yardage. Second down. Second down. Take a replay of that one. They hand it off to number 27, Charles Radigan. But he gets squashed by multiple men. Here comes the line on the 34 seconds left. Around the 30. Well, it's close to the 30. Almost into the end zone. And they'll hike. They'll throw it to Radic. No, they'll lateral it. And he trips. He's mad there. You can see the frustration, at least, when his fist hit the ground. But it keeps it going. Big slip there. And that, my friends, will end the third quarter. 21-14, Gilderland Dutchman. We'll be back in a few moments. Third quarter, 21-14, Gilderland Dutchman.
Yeah.
clear back. They're going to throw. He might scramble. He'll stay on. And he's got a first. He's still going. He'll break a tackle. He'll juke, collide with another man. Touchdown, Averill Park. Wow. Broke multiple tackles. Two defenders collided with each other. A wild play. And now it's a 1-point game. They could always connect. Let's see this again. Number 12. Galuski kept going. Broke, missed that one. There's the collision right there. Looks like they're okay. Oh, there's another one. Broke a, that man's ankles are broken in half. And now Averill Park is a, has a 1-point game behind Gilderland. And someone is hurt. The quarterback looks to be hurt, which is big. I don't know what happened with there. Multiple people are hurt. Number 23, it looks like, there is hurt. Getting treatment on it. Number 12 for Averill Park. Number 23 for Gilderland. And we're gonna be back in a couple of moments. 23 is up. Can he walk? There's 12. He's up. Both are up. 12 is wobbling. That could be huge in the future of this game. 23 is also wobbling. This could be big. Their quarterback got hurt. That is Quinn Orsini, hurt for the Dutchman. And that is Averill Park's quarterback, at least recently, Nicholas Galuski, also hurt. With their quarterback being hurt, this could be huge in the future of the game, of this game. We'll be right back after a few short moments. Back. They're gonna go for the extra point. The kick is up. Again, blocked. They keep it going. I don't even think they have made a single extra point tonight other than that 2-point conversion. We're back, ladies and gentlemen. Number 12 for Averill Park. Still hurt Galuski. They're gonna punt it or kick it off. If there's one thing we can say about Averill Park's kick game, is that they're good punts. They have good punts, good kickoffs. They just can't kick the ball. For an extra point. Four is still going. Four is still going. 30. 30. And he'll be tackled down at the 25. What a play for number four, Giovanni Simeone. Wow. He kept going and going and going. And now they're one step away of getting another touchdown. Woo. That's one of the most exciting plays tonight. The fans excited about that one. They're at the 28. What a return by number four, Giovanni Simeone. They're ready for the call. And here they go. Here comes the snap. They're waiting. I think they're calling for someone. Number six is not on. Okay. Well, snap out. They recover good. And there's Kapuzinski. Oh, no. I think they should have kept him in. They should have kept him out for a bit. Not right after he just got hurt. He's hurt again. Oh, man. We're going to take an injury timeout. We'll be back soon. 21-20, Gilderland Dutchman. Back after that injury break. They're gonna go for it. Look who's back. What a rush! What a rush! Number five! He'll be back to continue his reign of terror. Wow! Number five, Scusarella comes back. After looking like he was hurt, to get a big rush for the Dutchman.
The middle for the Dutchman.
10:04 left. Clock kind of skips down. They're going to add it back up. 10:01 left.
Gilderland.
First down, Dutchman.
Thank you.
First swinger ready. He'll throw. Caught by number one. Troy Verschwinger. That'll probably be just short, or maybe even made it. But it's going well. They're getting it done. Third and five. Could be third and four. It's around there. Third and five. And they're going to call timeout. It will be by Averill Park. Second timeout burned. 21-20. Gilderland Dutchman will be back in a few. Back. And I mean, after the timeout by Averill Park, they've been burning a lot of them. Gilderland, I don't think, has used one. No, they have used one. I'm sorry. And that will not break. Wait, Willie? Yes! Touchdown, Gilderland Dutchman. Number five, Michael Scuzzarella. With the touchdown rush, 27-20, Dutchman. He almost got tackled, broke two, and he'll get through. Falling down almost, and he's pumped. Dutchman in a very close game. 27-20. Here comes the snap. Kick is up. Kick is no good. That is Gilderland's first missed kick of the game. And that will give it a 7-point lead. Dutchman 27, Averill Park 20 with 8:25 left. We'll be back in a few. Back. Here comes the kick. Kick is up. And it's behind him. This could be huge. Can they tackle him back in? They'll get him down at the 15. What a play there. Kicked it behind him. And it gets him at the 15. Great field position for the Gilderland defense. They will start on the 15. They'll get it set on the line. Here comes the call. There he goes. They're gonna run it. And And it'll be sent packing.
No gain on the play.
Gershwinger with the tackle. That's Troy. And it will be a big loss of yardage with 8 minutes to go. Look at that. Got him good with a bit of help. Pushed him almost to the 10. 7:51 left. What a close game this is. 27-20. They're gonna go run it again. He'll be tackled behind them. That defense showing who's boss. They're having a night. And even though this is a close game, they're looking to win here in Mahanison. Wow. The defense pumped. 27-20, 3rd and 14. And here we go. 3rd and 14. And they're gonna stop it. They're gonna burn their final timeout.
6:45, left
quarter. That's, to me, a bit risky. They're still in it. And they want to win it. Of course they do. You always want to win in a football game. But for you burning all of your timeouts, I think, that's not the best with your 6:44 left in the game. And even though this isn't the arena game where it's 1 minute warnings and all that stuff, that's still not what you want. And here we go. They're back in.
Oh, Averill Park on 3rd and long. Back at the 10-yard line.
They're at the 10. A big, big hit. Might send them into the end zone. 6:44 left. 27-20 Gilderland. And here they go. They'll take the snap. Almost fumbled. And there will probably be a flag. It will be on Averill Park. Probably will be
false start.
That'll move him back. Stouffer. 3rd and 20. A lot of yardage to get to make up. And here comes the snap. He'll throw deep. Intercepted by number 11. That, my friends, is a pick six. Touchdown. Touchdown. Gavin Motto. What a play. Let's take a big replay on that one. Number 7 tried to throw long. That is Justin Matthews. Picked off by number 11. Gavin Motto, and they got it. Didn't get pushed out, barely got in. Touchdown, Dutchman. What a night they are having. 33-20. Will they get the extra point? The kick is up. And the kick is good. 34-20. Left in the fourth. 34-20 is the score. Fourth quarter. It's a close game, but it looks like Gilderland's going through. The crowd knows it. What a game they are having. We'll be back after a few short moments. Back. Fans are going loud here. Not even in their big home turf. Still powering and powering. Through number 56, it looks like. That is Karthik Kamanemi. And they're going to go for it. And he will be taken down. Nice tackle. 6:25 left. And they are short in the home crowd. They're on the third on. They're on the 34. They're about to get it done. What a game it's been. It looked back and forth, but a lot of missed extra points by Averill Park and a big interception for a pick six. It looks like it's going in Gilderland's favor, but you know, it's going to be big. And that will be Averill Park's final timeout. I know I said earlier that it looks like it wasn't, but now it is. We'll be back in a few short moments. 34-20, Gilderland Dutchman. They're getting it. This crowd, even not at the at GHS, they're in Mahanison, still pumped. The crowd cheering. They're ready to come home with a victory. 5:52 left in the fourth quarter. Here comes the snap. Gonna try to scramble. Fumble! Fumble! Who's got it? I think it's the Dutchman. That might put the nail in the coffin. Let's see the replay. He tries to run. Tries to scramble. There's the big hit. The ball fumbled. Even at this view, you can't even tell who's got it. What's it gonna be? It will be Dutchman ball. 5:36 left. Here in the fourth corner of the first game of the season under the Friday Night Lights. Here's the snap. He'll run. Good run. Wow, big big move there. Take a look at the replay. Scuzzarella still performing to expectations. If there even is one, he's been performing great. 5 minutes left. They'll take the snap. They'll rush again with him. He'll keep going. He'll keep going. He might go all the way. 10. Oh, just short. What a rush by number 5. And if there's one thing you can say about number 5's game, Scuzzarella, he has got it down. Performed multiple great plays. And he gets tackled in close to the end zone. First and 10. First and 10. They're gonna run. Will he get it? 32 still going. Oh, big hit. Out of bounds, but there is a flag thrown. We're going to see what this call is. What will it be?
And a flag on the play. Hold on, Bilderman.
Take a look under that one. You got, he tried to get him. Oh. Oh, big hit there. Got the shoulder. There's the flag. It will be on the Dutchman. I'd say it'd be a bit better if we heard what the refs are saying, but I mean, it doesn't matter. Still a great game of football. Team's doing good. We'll be back in a bit.
Still first down. Talk about the 18-yard line.
Still the first. 3:40 left. Here comes the snap. And that
down at the,
it'll be down 16, at the 16.
Second down.
Touchman have played a great game. And I mean, wow. A lot of good turnovers have helped them out. Both teams have gotten a fumble, recovered. And that's another missed play. That'll be a sack. But at least the Touchman will still have the ball. Third down. They don't turn it over, which could be good, because they can always come, because if that was fumbled and a couple of good throws happen, then he would have been, and he would have been out. And that would have been Averill Park's ball. Would have been a couple of good plays. They could throw it out, get a couple of points. I think probably try for it onside. And here goes the snap. He'll hurdle! Hurdle over the man! 10! He'll stay up, not out of bounds! Did he go out? He is out of bounds! Just sure, that might need a replay on that one. Here's a replay. What a play. Hurdled over a man. Look at it. He keeps going, going, going. Looked like he had a clean route to the end zone. Broke two tackles. Did he get out? Yes, he did. Unless he hit it. Did he hit it? It's close. They're down at real close.
1:54
left. They're going to probably run it. They have fourth and goal. This is big, big play. Do they get it? Yes, they do. Touchdown, Dutchman. Wow. A big, big run. And they'll get another one. 40-20. Who got it? I don't even know. Too crushed up in there to tell. And they're gonna go 4-2-1. They are going for two. They got it! Wow! A fake kick turns into a two-point conversion. 42-20, Gilderoy. Look at that again. Had enough room there to squeak in. Team got it. 1:48 left. But I mean, that's a big reason why Averill Park burned all their timeouts around the 6-minute mark. And now they have none while Gilderland has three, and they're winning. The Gilderland's winning by 22. They get the ball back, they just need to run it a lot and they'll get it done. And here they go, they're gonna kick. Could it be an onside? Keep the offense going. Will it just be a normal kickoff? They're gonna kick it short. Caught by 15, that's a fair catch. It'll be down. First and 10. Gilderland with a couple minutes left, are looking to finish the job. 42-20 here today. What a game played. Up and down for both teams. Big turnovers costed them the game for Averill Park if Gilderland wins. But it was close. Real close. First and 10 for Averill Park. And here we go. Fans knowing that this game is soon to be over. These fans cheering for their players. And the Red Sea with some of the biggest fans. And in our division, in our conference. They're gonna run it. He won't go far. Oh, big, big hit. 27 looks okay. And the fans, cheering. Replay it. Look at these fans, they know that everything is going their way. Look at this. Big tackle. And then the movement shift. Woo! Got him by the neck. 2 seconds left. The snap, quick run. Still going. And he's brought down. Is that a first? No, it is not. Third down. Whistles blow. Golderwood might have called a timeout. Oh, injury timeout. That's number 28. Jacob Phelps. He looks hurt. With 32 seconds left, Gilderland leading 42-20. We'll be back after a short break. 32 seconds left. Snap it. Here comes the... Oh, and it's behind him! He'll be tackled down. And there is the nail to the coffin. Fourth down. Game over. The Dutchmen win 42-20. What a game! That'll be it tonight. Thank you, Mahanasi, for hosting the game for us. We hope you drive home safely. Thanks for watching. I'm Anthony Bornt. So long, everyone.